galaxy commanders and welcome to this video for Infinite Galaxy. As you can see, I am on my account on server 52, and what I want to go through today is a quick guide or the most important things for new players to focus on. Because especially when you start again on a new server, you will see that there are quite a few players who really push away. Okay, these are high spenders, these are whales, but then there's a bulk of players all around the same power level, and then after this you will see players dropping off more and more. So what are the most important things? First, you want to build ships all the time. You never want to have your ship building run empty. And at this also, you want to unlock the additional shipbuilding slots. How do we unlock these? That's pretty simple. It's one of your buildings. The military dock, if you click here, you can see at level 1 you have one shipbuilding queue, at level 5 the second, at level 10 the third, and then you will get another one at 15. So try to push your military dock to these levels. Especially at the beginning, your command center might be higher than some of your other buildings. You see I have level 12 buildings and still some level 6 buildings. So make sure that every time you can get to one of these steps, 5, 10, 15, and then later 20, that you push through. Meaning, at the moment my military dock is at level 10, that is fine. But as soon as my command center hits 15, I will also make sure that I push my military dock to 15. It helps a lot getting these extra slots to build more ships and keep them busy as much as you can. And this brings us directly to how do we keep them busy, or with what are we keeping them busy?
Military.
We want to build the highest possible ships for this. So in your military research tree, you do have the different classes for cruisers, destroyers and frigates, and some of them or all of them are always limited by your research center. At the moment I cannot really continue here. I can already do some of the pre-requirements, but finally I will need to have my research center on level 13. Use the time till you get your research center to level 13 to do the other pre-requirements. Till tier 4 there are no real pre-requirements, you just need to get to this node in your research tree. But then for tier 5, you saw it here, I do need to research the shield for the frigates to level 3 before I can start this. So make sure you check these and you are well prepared that at the moment your research center hits, in this case level 13, you can directly start researching the next tier of these levels. I did make a video about all the different researches, so I don't want to go more into the detail there, but keep that in mind. One thing especially new players don't realize, you do have the defense platform here. If you do have enough resources, if resources are not a problem, you can upgrade these defense platforms. It is quite expensive to do that, but first they will give you additional defense against attackers, and you do also get these really nice buffs for all your ships when you get attacked. But on the second side, you will also get quite a lot of power value or power points for this. So if you are looking for like joining an alliance and they do have a power requirement, this might be an option to boost your power a little bit. As you see, this already gives me 42.6k power, which is quite a little bit at the beginning of the game. Next thing, crew members. Make sure that you do summon your crew members. Having an empty slot in the crew formation is not recommended. Level up crew members that you think are good and that you are going to use for a longer time. I did not level up much yet because I want to wait for Wednesday to see the final changes in the warship mechanics, and then I can see which kind of warship I will focus on. Always make sure that you do recruit your crew members, at least one crew member or at least one recruit per day. You do need this also for the daily missions. And that's one thing you should make sure you do your daily missions. You can see everything you have to do here. One of the things I said is recruit one crew member. Another thing is that you have to build one of the outfittings. So what I do there is I just build, okay, can't build the cannon at the moment. I just build one green staff, and directly after it is built,
You
I just
ready?
disassemble it in the
Active
outfitting
depot.
depot again. That is, we break it down. It is for free, and I get my resources back. But this way, I have done the part I need for the mission. The probably most important thing for new players to do is the campaign. Before we get to the campaign, let's have a quick look at the events, because this is also something you should do a lot. You do have 30 investigation energy every day. Use it. You do get some really nice rewards there. Especially the core XP will boost your core module up in level, and you can increase the different knots. You get more powerful. So don't forget to do this whenever you have time. Just send them for investigation, for exploring new systems. And yeah, don't let this energy go to waste. You do also need to do this for your main missions, for these global missions where you want to get through as fast as possible. Okay, most important thing, do
Campaign.
the campaign. Push the campaign as much as you can. In the early levels, you do get a lot of blueprints for the Hercules. I think nearly every level you do get these blueprints, and this will make you pretty strong. Still here, we get 40 blueprints for the Hercules. And when you do this, don't forget to upgrade your
Flagship.
Hercules. You already got these blueprints, so go to your flagship, to your Hercules, modify it, and bring it up. I didn't buy any blueprints for it. I'm already rank 4. I could now next rank it up to rank 5, which would also increase the first skill. So this will be for sure very beneficial to continue in the campaign. As soon as you are able to get the first skill on 3, you are able to finish the campaign to the last level. So if you can get there, do this. I just see I do also get enough blueprints now to build Nemesis. Building flagships also gives you additional power. If you use them or not is a different question, but having them increases your power rating, and this is something people will look for very often at the beginning and have minimum requirements for you to join alliances. If you already have a few Federation credits, you can go not to the VIP shop, to the blueprint shop, and check how many blueprints you can buy. At the moment, I could only buy 11 blueprints, so blueprint packs. That would be 110 blueprints. So this is not enough for me to rank up the Hercules to the next level. But yeah, do this as much as possible, and always go to your alliance, go to Alliance Tech, and donate. Why do you need to donate? So first, you do get Alliance Honor. So when we click here, we got 3 XP, 3 honor, and 3 of these building points. We do need the XP to rank up the Alliance tech, and this is important because your alliance wants to grow. You get more systems. More systems means that at the end you will have a bigger territory. A bigger territory means you do get more resources every day. So this is important not only for you, but also for the alliance. This is important for everyone. You do get the Alliance Honor. You can buy things in the Alliance shop, and believe me when I tell you, there will be really, really good things later. And that's the other thing. You do get also the points here to at one point upgrade the alliance, which then allows you to have more members in the alliance. It will rank up the alliance shop and also increases the number of territories you can get. So for these you need the alliance resource. And all of this comes mostly from donation early in the game. So donate whenever you can. It is not like you're giving away something. You do get so much from the alliance bonuses and everything that you really should do this every day as often as you can. Okay, so these are the most important things in my opinion that you need to do. Besides that, follow these main missions. You do get nice rewards and they will guide you pretty nicely. Send out your fleet to kill some pirates. You will get resources to build better equipment, which will help you everywhere else in the game. And yeah, I'll leave it with that. There are many more tips for the specific areas of the game, like tactical training base, campaign simulation center, all these things you also should do. For these, just check out my other videos. And if you didn't do it, give the video a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel, join us on Discord, and then I'll see you all on the next video again.